is the fourth incarnation of the Subaru Forester, a practical and no-nonsense 4x4 that has developed a reputation as a rugged workhorse, beloved by farmers and those that live in remote rural locations. Subaru even claims 75% of its cars are bought by country dwellers. It's not quite an all-new car, more of an extensive update of the outgoing model. The 13-ton Forester is longer and wider than the car it replaced, allowing greater interior space for both people and luggage. Sadly, like the previous version, it's a bit anonymous looking both inside and out. Despite a subtle redesign in 2016, the interior still falls short of its rivals thanks to a bland design, but it's solid and will likely last a long time. Genuine off-roadability. The Forester makes up for its cabin with decent driving dynamics, though. On the road it doesn't roll around anywhere near as much as you might expect from a tall 4x4 thanks to a comparatively low center of gravity, while off-road it makes a pretty good fist of things too. All Foresters are equipped with four-wheel drive. Subaru calls its system symmetrical all-wheel drive. Automatic versions include an X-mode function, which adjusts the gearbox, traction control and throttle settings to help the car find grip on muddy ground. It also incorporates hill descent control, which can ease the car down a slippery slope so the driver can concentrate on steering. Ground clearance of 220 mm is slightly more than the Devil Land Rover Discovery Sport, and it's far more capable than softer rivals such as the Toyota RAV4. Petrol and diesel engines. Subaru offers three engines, two petrol and one diesel. The entry-level petrol is a 2.0-litre engine with a 6-speed manual or CVT automatic transmission. Fuel consumption is improved over the older model with claimed average of 40.9 miles per gallon and 43.5 miles per gallon for the manual and CVT auto respectively. There's a potent turbocharged petrol XT version with 237 bhp and 350 Nm of pulling power, which is a genuinely fast car. The solitary diesel is a 2.0-litre turbocharged engine available with 6-speed manual or CVT automatic gearbox. It's a very easy-to-drive power plant on the road and makes up roughly half of all Forester sales. Well-suited to towing, the Forester is rated to tow up to 2,000 kg and is fitted with the trailer stability control system, which controls the braking system and power distribution to help bring weaving trailers and caravans under control. Roof rails are standard fit and top XT variants feature a powered tailgate so you don't need to get your hands muddy to open the boot, which will carry up to 4 golf bags. In fact, the whole car is bigger than the car it replaces, it's longer and wider than before to free up more interior and luggage space. It's a shame about those bland looks and that drab interior because, underneath, the Forester is a capable car that's likely to build upon the previous model's strong reliability record. To learn more, read on for the full Subaru Forester review. There's a choice of three engines, two petrol and one diesel. All three engines are 2.0-litre, four-cylinder units. They've already seen service in the previous Forester, but have been fettled for improved fuel economy and emissions for this generation. Diesel engine, you've got a choice of 6-speed manual and CVT automatic gearboxes, Subaru calls these linear-tronic. With the help of a turbocharger, the engine develops 147 horsepower and takes the Forester from 0 to 62 miles per hour in 9.9 seconds. It's flexible on the road, happy to lug along without the need to change gear too much to make progress. The 6-speed manual box itself is nice to use, with a notchy but precise action reminiscent of other Subarus such as the Impreza and BRZ. We haven't tried the CVT gearbox in the diesel Forester yet, but it's a good fit in other Subaru models so it should be a similar story in this car. Petrol engines. The petrol lineup begins with a 150 horsepower unit with start, stop, which can take the car from 0 to 62 miles per hour in 10.6 seconds and onto a top speed of 118 miles per hour. It's available with either a 6-speed manual gearbox, the last Forester had 5 speeds, or Subaru's linear-tronic CVT automatic option. The latter blunts the car's acceleration, 11.8 seconds to 62 miles per hour, and makes progress a noisy affair as the CVT setup means the revs rise for prolonged periods under acceleration. It's a helpful setup to have if you plan on going off-road, however, as it includes Subaru's X-mode system, which we'll cover later. The best Subaru Forester performance figures belong to the direct injection turbo, DIT, petrol engine. Available exclusively in Forester XT models, this develops 240 horsepower and pushes the car from 0 to 62 miles per hour in 7.5 seconds. Top speed is 137 miles per hour and there's 350 Nm of torque on tap, which makes it a pretty potent machine for overtaking. It's a very quick car. It's available with the Lineatronic CVT gearbox only, which feels better suited to the more powerful turbocharged petrol engine than the lower powered one. The Forester strikes a good balance between on- and off-road ability. On the tarmac, there's much less body roll than you might anticipate from a high-riding 4x4. This makes the car nicer to drive on twisty roads and means your passengers won't get thrown around too much either. This is thanks partly to the engine's low position in the car, giving the Forester a lower center of gravity than many off-roaders. The steering is very light, maybe too light for some drivers' tastes, but is direct and makes the car easy to drive around town, and easy to place on a twisty road. The ability to handle adverse driving conditions is an important selling point for the Forester. It's a much better off-road proposition than many other SUVs out there that have the look but not the ability. It's a surprisingly effective off-roader. Lineatronic automatic versions are fitted with Subaru's X-Mode system, which puts the engine, gearbox and traction control system into a setting designed to help with off-road driving. Throttle response is dampened, the traction control becomes more sensitive and a hill descent control function is enabled below speeds of 12 miles per hour, keeping the car under control when driving down steep slopes. A graphic on the display screen lets you know what the system's up to and shows the angle of the front wheels, which is helpful if you're not sure which way they're pointing when they're spinning on mud, for example. It's important to know where you'll end up when the tires gain some traction. Sadly, this is an area in which the Forester lags behind its rivals. Although the interior isn't the sea of hard plastics you'd find in some Subarus of old, it's still not the most inspiring place to be. The dashboard is clad with a soft touch finish and the center console has been given a brushed effect featuring the brand's latest infotainment system, but the overall interior design looks and feels dated when compared with new arrivals, as if from a car far older than one launched in 2013. Nevertheless, it's all logically laid out and you'll quickly feel at home. The steering wheel adjusts for both rake and reach and includes controls for the upgraded, easy-to-use audio system and cruise control. The driving position is high, offering a commanding view of the road ahead. A large powered sunroof available for certain trim levels is a nice addition which lifts the interior's ambience a little. There are plenty of cubby holes for storing items, and the USB and ON ports for the audio system are located in the center storage box so MP3 players and the like can be hidden away out of sight. While the interior materials aren't all that pretty, they do feel hard wearing, which is an important characteristic for the car's target market. Although the interior is a little bland, it's a spacious and comparatively comfortable place to spend time. Forward visibility is excellent as the Forester's windscreen pillars have been moved forwards compared with the previous model and the wing mirrors moved to the doors, which also allows the doors themselves to open wider for easier access. Like many 4x4s, there is a reasonable amount of wind noise at speed, but it's not enough to spoil Subaru Forester comfort levels too much. More intrusive is the engine noise from petrol cars equipped with the CVT automatic transmission, which has a characteristic tendency to hold the revs sky high for lengthy periods of time, even when accelerating gently. This is less of a problem in the more powerful turbocharged car, however. The seats are comfortable, whether wrapped in fabric trim or the X-Team model's leather upholstery. High-end trim levels feature an 8-way adjustable powered driver's seat, which makes it quicker and easier to find the right driving position. Ride and body control are very good for a 4x4 and the low center of gravity means passengers won't get thrown around too much on winding roads. The trim level setup for the Forester can be a little confusing at first glance, as there are different trims available depending on which of the three engines you go for. Diesel versions are available in two trims, XC and XC Premium, the lower powered petrol variant is available in X and X Premium, and finally, the powerful turbocharged petrol version is available in XT trim only, which is the best equipped of the lot. Standard Subaru Forester equipment X and XC spec Foresters get automatic air conditioning, 17-inch alloy wheels, roof rails, a USB and ON port for the stereo, Bluetooth connectivity, automatic lights and wipers, a large sunroof and a hill start assist system. There are two ISOFIX child seat points in the rear seats and front, side, curtain and knee airbags are standard. There's no manual on, off switch for the front passenger airbag. Instead, it becomes active automatically only if an adult is sat in the passenger seat. Automatic versions get steering wheel-mounted gear change control paddles and also benefit from the X-mode off-road setting and hill descent control, described in the driving and performance section. Step up to XC, X Premium if you want leather upholstery, an electric driver's seat, keyless entry and ignition and an electric tailgate. These models also came with sat-nav as part of Subaru's Starlink touchscreen infotainment system. Top of the tree is the XT specification, only available with the most powerful petrol engine. It can be distinguished visually by larger 18-inch wheels, extra vents on the front bumper and privacy glass. Gone is the distinctive bonnet air scoop that typified the old Forester Turbo, the vent is now hidden underneath the bonnet. Inside, there are leather seats, aluminium pedals, an engine start button and a sat-nav unit which includes European mapping and real-time traffic information. The XT also features a powered tailgate operated from a switch on the dash, the key fob or via a button just above the number plate. There's also a collection of optional Subaru Forester accessories, including a Subaru branded roof box and rear-mounted bike rack. You'll also be pleased to hear there's loads of towing kit available. Subaru Forester safety levels are impressive. It has been awarded a 5-star rating by the Euro NCAP safety body with a score of 91% for both adult and child occupant protection. It also scored full marks for side impact protection and offers greater pedestrian impact protection than the previous generation car. Stiffer framed seats than before promised to reduce the potential for whiplash and an array of airbags, front, side, curtain and knee, are standard. There's no manual on, off seat for the front passenger airbag. Instead, it becomes active automatically only if an adult is sat in the passenger seat. The Forester features an updated emergency brake assist system, which Subaru says can give the car almost identical braking performance on both wet and dry surfaces. There's also a trailer stability control system which uses the car's brakes and four-wheel drive system to help prevent trailers and caravans from weaving or becoming unstable in high winds. This generation Forester is a little wider than the old one and has a longer wheelbase, the distance between the front and rear wheels, creating more interior and luggage space. There's plenty of space for all the family thanks to generous head and legroom. The rear seats fold easily in a 60-hours-40-minutes split and the rear seat belts are handily positioned in a guide channel to keep them out of the way so that they don't become caught when the seats are folded. They fold completely flat and flush with the boot floor, which is great for loading and transporting big, heavy items. XC, X Premium and XT versions come with the powered tailgate as standard, which can be set to open to a pre-programmed height if you have a low garage ceiling, for example. There's no severe load lip to worry about when loading items into the boot and there are some cubby holes underneath the boot floor for stowing items out of sight. The tailgate itself is nice and wide and the parcel shelf can be stored under the boot floor. There's a space saver spare wheel as standard too. A clean sill design with seals along the bottom edge of the doors prevents mud from making its way onto the door sills, meaning you're less likely to get mud on your clothes when getting in and out of the car.